Yeah.
Yo, we do that bar again.
Yeah, go ahead. Wait. First of all, you have to let them know. First, I introduced myself to Vector, and he told me this is how you know people are in sync. So my official names, first of all, there are many: Willis Wayne, Edwin Opio, Tonde Raburu. But the ones with the idea are Willis Wayne Raburu.
Yeah.
And then you said,
I'm Bruce Banner, Bruce Wayne, and Bruce Lee. Funny how none of these boys could Bruce me. Bruce Willis, die hard for you, baby, make I take you gym. Wait, carry, wait, fill up. Bruce Almighty. Jump out.
Absolutely great, man.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Those are amazing bars. I'd like to know, though, coming up, like, what are your... like your inspirations, you know, who did you listen to and say, hey, I want to do that?
Well, my inspiration expands to like hip hop. So you could go from Ice Cube, Ludacris, Jay-Z, Miriam Makeba.
Diversity.
Yusun Do.
Yes.
So my dad was a wannabe DJ.
Wannabe DJ.
Yeah, like he's a police officer.
Okay.
Well, he passed in 2017.
Right, sorry.
Yeah. Thanks. But he always played music, so it was a 360 for me.
Right.
And I was born in a white garment church in Nigeria.
Uh-huh.
So one thing the white garment church is known for is raw music.
Right.
So whether you are performing on the instrumental or on the music, you're singing regardless.
Right.
Hence the performance. So that's the come up.
Mm.
Yeah.
And so, like, you know, whenever you were ready to put out your first track, like, what was that feeling like? Were you like, this is it, I'm about to blow up, or I'm so scared, I don't know if they're going to like me? How was it for you?
Nah, I was busy saying, so this is what you want to do. Like, I was like, okay, so I was just following whatever it is that I was doing, because nobody really plans the blow up, you know,
right,
what I mean?
Right.
So I'm like, hey, it's like this, so yeah, let's go now.
Yeah.
So I was just following destiny, and I'm a strong believer in African spirit.
Right.
So hence why I'd be out here and I'll vibe with you easy, because it's spirit for me over position.
That's right.
So I just followed the spirit, and it's led me here on this stage tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you know, how was it for you, you know? We know we went through the whole pandemic and everything, and everybody, we just had a group here who talked about how it really gave them time to, you know, get down and work on the music. How is the pandemic period for you? I mean, we're still in it, but yeah, how is it for you?
Well, the pandemic period gave the audience of music enough reason to scrutinize what they're paying for.
Ah.
You know, like, because you're locked down, you're on lockdown, so...
Yes.
It's not just paying for any type of music. You wanted music that made sense to you.
Mm-hmm.
And that made sense for me. Because somehow, spiritually, I was feeling something was coming. I said it to my whole team. Something to come. I shouldn't say something to come. And then COVID hit.
Right.
And every other musician that was, no offense or no shade, but any other musician that was pretty much like on the surface kind of like fell off.
Right.
Because it's COVID. People are trying to... economize their money,
right?
So you don't have to pay for trash music anymore,
right?
So it left the real musicians on the top of the list, and the whack ones on the whack ones.
Yeah. You know? So there was sort of like a sifting, right? So
yes, yeah. COVID kind of like sieved through all the facade,
right?
And the real became, you know.
Real recognized real, basically.
You know?
Yeah, that's what happened. All right, so tell us a little bit about, you know, first of all, what brings you to this beautiful country?
Calligraph Jones. No, okay, so...
Yeah.
The thing is, so I've always wanted to come, like... I think that what Africa needs now is unity more than anything.
Yeah.
So, for example, when we landed in Nairobi, Kenya, first thing I was like, in the bus, I was like, no, play local music.
Right.
So we'd be able to make dope fusions off of that over anything else. So me coming here is pretty much like communicating with the locals, like the real people, and not just the PR people. You know, the PR people are usually like all nicely dressed and everything, but I want to experience the real life, and this is my first time in Kenya, actually.
Oh, wow. Yeah. What's the experience like so far?
I didn't know Kenya was cool, though. Like, look at me, I was out there saying, I don't think we need sweatshirts in Kenya, though. And I'm here like, wait, lions stay in the cold? Wow. Okay, Leo. but I've had a great time. The people in Kenya are super cool. You know what I mean? Yeah. Unlike Nigeria, where I'm super hype. Mm. So it's a good balance for me. And I might as well just get real estate here.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah.
Get some stuff. So, of course, we're looking forward to probably working with more artists here as well. As you said, listen, get that fusion and that spirit connection as well. So what are you planning? What are your projects? I know we just have like a couple of days to Christmas. But what are your plans for the remainder of the year and into next year?
I'm just here connecting with the spirits in Africa. It's the best way to be.